that are not in your orders of service. But I want you to join in by saying, when I give a pause, blessed be God forever. You remember that? Blessed be God forever. So praise God who loves us, God who cares. The love of God is like the light in our darkness. Blessed be God forever. We praise you, our God, for all mothers who have loved and laughed and labored as they cared for their children. Blessed be God forever. We praise you, our God, for all mothers who have wept in sorrow and joy for their children. Blessed be God forever. We praise you, our God, for Jesus, born of a woman and nurtured in her love, and for Mary, a reminder of your patient waiting love. Blessed be God forever. God of compassion, whose Son Jesus Christ, the child of Mary, shared the life of the home in Nazareth, and on the cross drew the whole human family to himself. Strengthen us in our daily living, that in joy and in sorrow, we may know the power of your presence to bind together and to heal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. So let's stand as Jenny reads our gospel for us.
So it's John chapter 19, verses 25 to 27. Hear the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Near the cross of Jesus stood his mother's sister Mary, the wife of Clopas, and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus saw his mother there and his disciple whom he loved standing near, he said to his mother, "Dear woman, here is your son." And to the disciple he said, "Here is your mother." From that time on, the disciple took her into his home. Praise to you, O Christ.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Lord, thank you for our young people here this morning. We pray that you bless them as they learn more about you and do their activities, and we look forward to seeing them later on this morning.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, open our hearts and ears to your word and teach us each day. Amen. So, here we are on Morning Sunday. And I hope for all the mothers here you got off to a good start. Of course, you got breakfast and bread. No? No? Okay. Got children running around pandering to your every whim? No? Right, okay. Not doing very well so far. Flowers bursting around the house and boxes of chocolates. Yes? Oh, God, well, I can get that. Okay. And the box of chocolates sufficient to get through the whole series of Midsummer Murders, is that right? Okay. I'm sure the thought was there, maybe there's a surprise lunch coming. But we'll have to see. Karen was asking what was happening for lunch, and said, "But I'm now asking children, I'm not your son." Don't think I've got away with it that easy, so. So do you believe in Mumbling Sunday? Or do you believe it's just a marketing opportunity for greeting cards in the street? No. Is Mumbling Sunday a time to give a little back to our mothers who have given us so much? Or is it really about last minute flowers and boxes of chocolates? Before I go on, not everybody has a good experience of motherhood, either as a parent or from the perspective of being a child. I must make it clear, Mothering Sunday is not for everyone. It can be a difficult time for some. There's many women who would love to become a mother, but for some reason they couldn't. Some people didn't have the best mother in the world, and others simply just didn't get on. While others who did may have lost them through death. And sadly, some mothers have lost children. where others carry the guilt of the prodigal children. To them, mothering Sunday is very difficult, and an understanding of this certainly helps. We also remember this morning, we pray, despite their troubles, this is a special day for you. Recently, I was reading a story on the internet of a little girl who had a double transplant. Her father gave his liver, her mother gave a kidney. This poor girl received this double transplant and was the first child in Britain to receive double transplants from both parents. When the parents spoke, they showed it was clearly not a decision they had any difficulty over. Their child needed something which they had, and so they were willing to give freely. This sacrificial love is something that we recognise very easily in Jesus. We can know that God loves us like the very best human parent. He too forgives us freely. God knows that his children, we all make mistakes, and to err is human. We know from the way that Jesus treated people who had made terrible mistakes in their lives, that God doesn't use that as an opportunity to criticise us, but rather to forgive and hold out for the opportunity to try again. Just like those parents, we also see in Jesus' example of that self-giving love. Jesus is shown to love us so much he's prepared to die for us, and at Easter he made that very clear at his crucifixion. So what can we learn as a church from the example of good parents, of good mothers, of the teaching life example of Jesus? First of all, it's good to be reminded that we're all God's children. Every single one of us is a child of God. We have a shared parenthood by virtue of our common humanity and demonstrated by baptism. Today we remind ourselves of the fact that we are all part of God's family. Jesus told us that we can speak to God as we speak to an earthly parent. We're all the children of God, and the church should be able to embrace all of God's children and welcome them with love, which demonstrates the best quality of parenthood. So to that extent, we're able to think of a mother church which loves all of God's children as God loves them himself. One day, a little girl was sitting and watching her mother doing dishes, and she suddenly noticed that her mother had several strands of white hair sticking out from her brunette head. The little girl asked, "Why are some of your hairs white, mummy?" The mother thought. She was being smart when she replied, "Well, every time you do something wrong and make me cry or unhappy, one of my hairs turned white." The little girl thought for a moment and said, "So how come all grandmother's hairs are white?" True motherhood is a lifetime task. It is not easy by the time the child reaches 18. Mother has had to handle some extra 18,000 hours of child generation work. One mother said, "The joy of motherhood is what a woman experiences when all the children are finally in bed." I've got a few people nodding there. But true motherhood is a calling, a privilege, and if handled right, a pleasure. Two young children presented their mother with a house pack for Mother's Day. They'd used their own pocket money and she was thrilled. The other one said with a sad face, "It was a really beautiful bunch of flowers at the flower shop, and we really wanted to give you them, but they were really dear, and it had a nice ribbon in it and said, 'Rest in peace.'" But we thought, "You're perfect since you're always asking for a little peace so you can have some rest." True motherly love is unselfish and unconditional to the last. Mums invest their love in us from day one, or to be precise, from 9 months before day one. They shower love upon us because of who we are, not what they think they will get from you. What they will get if they're really successful is a monosyllabic teenager who doesn't want to be seen dead with them. Now, this is going to make you look educated. Very hard. The Greeks have three words for love. The first is eros, a romantic love between two people. The second is philia, a brotherly love between friends. And thirdly, there's agape, the most pure form of love. Agape is more near us. It is more than filial. Agape is a love that seeks nothing in return. It is an overflowing love. That's what theologians will call the love of God, working in the lives of men and women. And when you rise to love on this level, you begin to love men and women, not because they are likeable, but because God loves them. You love them every person, and you love them because you know God loves them. And they may be the worst person you've ever seen, but God still loves them. And I think this is what Jesus means when he says, love your enemy. It's significant he doesn't say, like your enemy. Like it is a sentimental something, an affectionate something. There are a lot of people that I find difficult to like. I don't like what they do to me. I don't like what they say about me and other people. I don't like their attitudes. I don't like some of the things they're doing. And they probably don't like me. But Jesus says, love them. And love is greater than like. Love is understanding, redemptive goodwill for all men. So when you love someone, and here comes the point to love the individual who does the evil deed while hating the deed. This is what Jesus means when he says, love your enemy. And I know it's easier said than done, but it's sometimes we must aspire to. Today we celebrate all those who are mothers, not just our own mothers, but other people here who are mothers to those who are not their children. How can someone be a mother to me when they're not my mother? Okay, let's look at what mothers do. Mothers are great because they love us. To love someone means they put themselves, someone else's need before their own. Mothers are great because they train us. To train someone means to help someone to become better at something. Mothers are great because they comfort us. They comfort us when we're lonely, or perhaps when someone has been horrible to us in school. Mothers are great because they look after us when we're ill. They look after us when we're not very well, or wake up in the middle of the night, poorly. Mothers are great because they care for us. Our mothers care for us when we're sad. I wonder if you can think of anyone who does these things who's not your mother. When we look at what mothers do for us, we can see that there's so much that we can let God do for us as well, if we would let him. He wants to be our spiritual mother and father. To God, there is no difference. So Mothering Sunday teaches us something very important. It teaches about the nature of love in its purest and unblemished form. Motherly love given unconditionally and unselfishly. A love that shows us here on earth the nature of that love that our Father in heaven has for each and every one of us, his errant children. God's love, just like mother's love, is given freely and unconditionally. God showers us with love and leaves us to make our own decisions, our own mistakes. And let's be honest, we do make some bad ones. But none of these errors makes any difference to that nature, that unending love from God. That love that God gives us as our Heavenly Father and our Heavenly Mother. Amen.
Thank you.
commandment I give to you, that you should love one another as I have loved you. By this everyone will know that you are my disciples. So let us reflect on God's word and dance for his help. Let us confess our sins. Loving God, your love gives us life, yet we often fail to live as your children. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Loving God, you call us to live in the light, yet we often prefer to hide in the darkness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Loving God, you hear us when we cry for help, but we often ignore the cries of others. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may the God of love bring us back to himself, forgive us our sins, and assure us of his eternal love, in Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Let us pray. As his mother and son death, let us pray to our loving parent God, as joined in one family. On this special day, we thank you, Heavenly Father, for mothers, for all they mean or have meant, for the love they have shown and the care they have given. We thank you for the qualities of mothers, their patience, their kindness, concern and understanding. We thank you for the part they play in our lives, and we thank you for this day of saying thank you, this opportunity to say what we so often mean to say and so really do. For mothers and motherhood, for children and families, we bring you this day our grateful praise. Amen.
Amen.
We also pray for new mothers coming to terms with new responsibility, to expectant mothers wondering and waiting, for those who are tired and stressed or depressed, for those who struggle to balance the tasks of work and family, for those who are unable to feed their children due to poverty, for those whose children have physical, mental or emotional disabilities, for those who have children they do not want, for those who raise children on their own, for those who have lost a child, for those who care for the children of others, for those whose children have left home, and for those who desire to be a mother as not being fulfilled. Bless all mothers, that their love may be deep and tender, and that they may lead their children to know and do what is good living, not for themselves alone, but for God and for others. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We thank you, loving God, for our church here at St. James, and for all those who worship here as a family. We pray for Heather and for our readers, Ron, Mike and Liz, as they lead us in worshiping Sunday, and pray that this church will grow in years to come. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, we pray today for all those caught up in violence, remembering especially the people of Ukraine, that in this time of fear and conflict they may know God's presence and peace. We pray for world leaders, that guided by integrity and wisdom, they may work together so that peace may flourish. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for our parish and our local community, that in this time of Lent we may reach out in solidarity to our brothers and sisters in need. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We bring before you now those known to us who are in any sort of need at this time. In a moment of silence, we name them in our hearts and commit them to your loving care. Let those who mourn, we pray, feel your healing touch in their lives, and that through your grace they come to know your peace. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, we remember in your presence all those who have died, and particularly those we have known and loved. Thank you for them, and thank you for your promise of eternal life and peace. May we comfort one another through your love. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Loving God, trusting in your promise to hear us when we pray in faith, we ask you to bless all our relationships in the families of our homes, our church and our communities, so that through our lives your loving will for us may be done. Amen.
Might at the beginning of the sermon already mentioned that Mothering Sunday can be a sometimes Loving God, as we remember with thanksgiving those who showed us and loved us, we bring to you our memories, our hopes, and our dreams, and offer them all to you. Where we are weak, give us strength. Where we are broken, bind us up and heal us. Where we are empty or despairing, give us hope. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
offer one another a sign of God's peace. We may find a voice to praise your name.
Thank you.
hands, O Lord, as a mother tenderly gathers her children, you embrace the people as your own. When they turned away and rebelled, your love remained steadfast. From them you raised up Jesus, our Saviour, born of Mary. He offered his life for sinners, and with a love stronger than death, he opened wide his arms on the cross. On the night before he died, he came to supper with his friends, and taking bread, he gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to them, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." At the end of supper, taking the cup of wine, he gave you thanks and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." Great is the mystery of faith. We remember his dying and rising in glory, and we rejoice that he intercedes for us at your right hand. Pour out your Holy Spirit as we bring before you these gifts of your creation. May they be for us the body and blood of your dear Son. Bring us at the last with all your people to the vision of that eternal splendor for which you have created us through Jesus Christ our Lord. By whom and with whom and in whom, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, we worship you, Father Almighty, in songs of everlasting praise. Every time we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he together the prayer after communion. God of our pilgrimage, you have fed us with the bread of heaven. Refresh and sustain us as we go forward on our journey. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Well, shall we see what the children have been doing this morning? What have we made this morning? Mum's a superhero, aren't they? Yeah. So we've made the superheroes. But we played a game as well. We've got a minute to play again.
Yeah!
Who's going to do the game? Who's going to show? We played Flip the Flower this morning. I'll just put a few on. Who's going to do a flip?
No.
Go on, show us how to do a flip.
your mum. So, what's mum's favourite colour? All your secrets came out this morning. Very carefully.
Green.
What else?
I got
what's that?
Who is the best friend?
Yeah! You can ask your mummy later. So you need to make sure that all the ladies, in a minute, when we've said this prayer, get a rose and a card. You remember that?
Yeah.
And if your mum is here, you definitely need to give her a rose and a card. All right? So give your mummy one first, and then help with giving everybody else one. Okay? Okay. So let's say this prayer together. On the back of our order of service, where it says distribution of the flowers. Thank you, God, for the love of our mothers. Thank you, God, for their care and concern. Thank you, God, for the joy they share with us. Thank you, God, for the pain they endure for us. Thank you, God, for all they give us. Thank you, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. For you, isn't it? Aren't they lovely?
Do you want to take the basket?
Yeah, and then take the basket round.
Thank you.
giving life to all creation, bless us. May God, who was born of an earthly mother, bless us. May God, who broods as a mother over her children, bless us. May Almighty